horrible for backbreaker. It killed families and everything else because the mileage was so bad.
Out to Oklahoma territory for Leroy McGurk. We had a hell of a good run.
That's what he's going to learn. First of all, you're going to drive 20 godly miles for $25. And then you're all going to fight to get to bed in a hotel room.
And you'd be in Oklahoma City, Tulsa one night, and roll Louisiana the next night.
I wrestled him, I don't know how many times. I never felt uncomfortable with him at all. And, I mean, you knew his background, of course.
You will pay. And it's not a threat. It will happen.
Daddy Hodge and I were partners. Now, at 1972, we made the split, and I had a lot of heat.
They built it up good. We went into this big auditorium there in Oklahoma City, pretty well sold it out, and it was Danny Hodge against Angelo Savoldi for the world's junior heavyweight champion.
I love Bill Watts. I never had a problem with Bill Watts. All the stories I hear are probably true, but I never had that kind of relationship with him.
So as it turns out, Bill was doing all the work.
I own this territory. I pay the bills, and I'm going to listen to what Buck Wilbury has to say.
The Kentuckians, what you saw in the ring is what you saw on the street.
Leroy McGurk, if you've got that bull rope match sanctioned, me and Carl Cox are going to warm things up.
By the time he'd land on the arena floor, it was like parting the Red Sea. People were terrified of him.
He put the miles into this group. No doubt about that.
A little different story at Tulsa. I tied him up. I didn't hurt him, but I tied him up pretty bad. And he said, well, he says, you learned really well, kid.
I had a baby actually thrown at me in a riot.
But the very first real angle I did with anything of that wrestler was to kill himself up.
But Danny Hodge is the bar none, toughest, most imposing, dangerous human being that ever walked the face of the earth.
Leroy said, I can't use you anymore, Wick. He said, all promoters are going to hear that you didn't like the payoff, so you need to get out of promoters.
I done heard the call of my friend Stan Hansen.
Andre the Giant is 7 feet 4 inches tall, 485 pounds.
I never seen a day when I couldn't put the Oklahoma ride on some barroom brawler.
In a small territory like Louisiana, we got Shreveport, you got Baton Rouge, you got Alexandria, you got Monroe, and New Orleans, different areas like that. You have to build those towns.
Of the feud between the Fantastics and the Sheepherders.
Chavo gets an amazing reception.
My God, he's brain-busting on the concrete!
Universal Wrestling Federation rule book has been just thrown out the window.
You just see me right now.
Jake the Man and the DDT Lander.
It was only a matter of time.
Old Skandar Akbar, the man that burned me. I haven't forgotten you either, tough guy.
I will catch up any day of the week, 2 times on Sunday.
Let's go, hunt him out.
I don't pull punches one way or the other with anybody.
If you're afraid, say you're afraid.
Well, Chris Adams, maybe I'm tired of waiting for you. Maybe I'm tired of carrying you all the time.
But you're not bigger than Ric Flair. You know why? Because I'm the world champion. Woo!
You blew it, sweet dad, and nobody does that to me.
Call me a liar, slap your face real good in the general public.
That square circle is the dog's yard, and nobody runs the dog's side of his yard.
And you write it down in your book.
You are out, and I am in.
The only thing for me to do is retire the television title.
I made a fool out of you and Mitch South.
We're not the kind of guys that can be bought, though.
It's got to get down to the basics. Back to the basics!
Give me a second, I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom getting higher than the Empire State. My lover, she's waiting for me just across the bar. My seat's been taken by some sunglasses asking about a scar. And I know I gave it to you months ago. I know you're trying to forget. But between the drinks and subtle things, the holes in my apologies, you know, I'm trying hard to take it back. So if by the time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight. No, I know that I'm not all that you got. I guess that I just thought maybe we could find new ways to fall apart. But our friends are back, so let's raise a towel. Cause I found someone to carry me home tonight. We are young, so closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight.
You know it's hard, man,
when you walk into your house and the first thing you see is your little child run up to you and she said, Dad, are you all right? I saw this big old man jump on your back and trying to hang you, Dad. I was reading stuff like that in the history book, but I told him, phase that out of your mind, Keisha. Leave it up to your dad, because this is one thing I do, and that's fight real good.